There we go. I'm just gonna rename it to that, because honestly, that's a bit more fitting for how the split actually goes. Like, seriously, you look at that image and you think, ah, he got that on Esme first turn, didn't he? No, I wouldn't be complaining about it if it was Esme first turn. That's literally like Esme's second turn after I had like both merchants. By the way, both merchants outspeeding her. Prim not outspeeding her. She kills Prim. I revive her to, like, you know, re-roll her speed. Roll or whatever this game does. And then she still ended up last. If you get that turn order on turn one, you think, hey, this game's fucking stupid. But, you know, you'll at least get to sidestep on both merchants and then just hope you win the 50-50 on her not attacking Pram. Like, I'm honestly not even too cross with that turn order on turn one, but when it's like turn two, after Prim died, she was slower than Esme on both of Esme's turns. She gets killed by Esme, and then you revive her to re-roll her speed. And she still goes behind. Not only both merchants are ahead of Esme, but both of Esme's turns still. Like, what the fuck am I supposed to do? I don't understand. How do I win? Entire time I've been ranting about Esme turn order bullshit. I might have actually gotten a gold here. This was really fast. I mean, what are the chances I'm actually going to find a Kate on this one though? 451 though. That was also a dumb thing on that last run. Or what? Was that the one that he skipped an encounter here? I don't think it was. Never mind. I was thinking I skipped an encounter, but then died to Noble Court. I did skip an encounter and died to Noble Court, but not in the same run. What are the chances that I find the cave? Time for this to be a 38. Shut up about the Ismay speed thing. Just let the splits talk for themselves. Okay. I was gonna say, I probably should have considered using a band on those. Cursed by Mags here. I mean, I don't know. Not too much of a curse, really. I got to save. I not only got a gold there, but I got to save 2,500 leaves, which is huge. I can teleport to places. seriously, like, still thinking about it. Instead of buying an L instead of two M's. I'll sit on it, see how many bandits I end up possibly using. Might just end up buying an extra M or something instead, I don't know. Actually got the run, all right. Okay. Hands are getting a little sweaty here now. What the heck? There's like things I needed. Definitely think I'll go for the L stone. That. I've got so much of a lead. Not mean to do that. Not even gold because of the encounter in that. Goes to show how shaky my hands are right now. I'm ahead of my song best. Right now. No, previous song of best. Still by the shadow. Got win for Omar, shadow will be for Heathcote. Bandits for random encounter. Okay. I'm actually nervous about how fast this run is. Really?
Yes.
Whatever. I didn't get either encounter. I'll take it. Yeah, I know. As a matter of fact, at the beginning of this run, I was ranting about Esme and why I changed my split. My final split to that. That you see. Thanks for good luck, though. Oh, yeah. I need to compare it to some of the best, otherwise I'm just gonna lose it, dude. Thing is, I'm even ahead of my summer best. By the way, of course you show up, Magus. You're the first one to show up. This run had the double cave. I got to save 2,500. No dancers in Noble Court. Okay. Yeah, that's why you woke up, yeah. There's the connection between you and getting multiple Kates. Classic. Okay, don't kill him. really don't kill Prim. No? You wanna fucking kill Prim? You wanna kill everyone, actually. Alright. Well then. No one needs gold. That's mercenary. Didn't throw. Yeah. Yeah, it was going too well. This is still 37 pace. Somehow. If things go perfect. That ain't gonna happen, obviously, but... yeah. Force of Purgation. We do it instead of Force of Purgation. Usually we tend to cut back on the stones and whatnot. In place of it. But, yeah. Because I got, several discounts, and, I can... Speaking of, but yeah. I got several discounts, so I was able to just also throw out 2M stone purchases and get an L stone that I don't usually get. Usually I'm carrying 2M stones for whatever is in Morlock's Mance. As you saw, the Mance has some pretty nasty encounters. So being able to kill them in one turn instead of one action instead of two is a pretty big deal. Okay. Saved Wendell. What is that? I can still 37 if everything goes perfect. I mean, I wanted to see if I could possibly see the helm. Kinda cheeky, but yeah. I figured since my goal does not keep the Wendell, so that's a pretty chunky time save already. Had a really big discount off that shield, which is why I was considering it.
Thank you.
No misclicks. No misclicks. No misclicks. Don't fucking do it. I've already choked it once. You're not doing it again. Oh my god, dude, it's like, I should've just taken the helm off, it's not a 37, dude. I should've just taken the stupid helm off. Why did I not take the helm off?
Oh, yours.
Just take the helm off and you've got a 37. Oh, one and done. One and done the record. I guess it's not one and done. I was ranting pretty hard at the start of this run because of the previous run that I did get a real Kate on. I grinded for a real Kate and it was like essentially second run anyways, and this was third run of the day. I also get another real Kate, and then I find another real Kate in double core. It saves me money, lets me buy that L-stone. Not only that, I run away from the grand board encounter, dude. Oh my god. Looks at the uptime. I'm not even going to bother looking at it. Oh man. All right. Jesus. Imagine this run, but without getting surprised and murdered in Morlock's Manse. That's, I can't even imagine. Yeah, oh yeah, I know there's worse. Yeah. As you can see, I'm ahead of my time of best at Therion, so I think there were maybe a few encounters along the way that I skipped at that point. Oh. I'm gonna say, like, it's not hopeless to beat this run, if you want. As you saw, I didn't get the first turn break Esme. I got killed. Not only killed in Morlock's Manse, so I didn't get the first turn break on Esme. It takes time doing that recovery. Although that was turn two. I wasn't expecting Prim to be first on turn two. It would have worked out, I think, because everyone was out turning Esme on turn three as well. But yeah, speed kick W, by the way. Well, you can still get... I think there was, it was the tutorial video I posted the other day. I technically, because of sidestep, could even do a turn 2 break on Esme. I hit sidestep with Therion. You leg hold with Tressa, revive with Prim, and then you break on turn 2. You go from there. You can't do that if it's Tressa is the one that uses sidestep and gets double targeted though. But yeah, there's even if you want to beat this time, you can still go for sidestep, depending on your pace, obviously. Depending on your pace, I mean. Save a billion, not menuing? I mean... that is true. Well, you also save a billion not needing to grab the windmill. Or at least doing it without risk. You can grab it at not too big of a time loss with a 25% encounter risk. Just grab the Thunder L. And get lucky. Is the Thunder L faster? I mean, it is true, just get lucky though. That part certainly is true. I guess maybe one last thing. I'm not going to be doing more runs, but I'll check the steps on Thunder L. Since it is apparently highly praised. Yeah, that's what I meant. Like, you gotta sacrifice, what, probably 10 seconds in order to get it without risk? Windell, that is. Oh yeah, to beat this time, I mean... as I mentioned, it really just depends on your pace. I mean, you get what I did, and, you know, let's say you have to use the L-Stone on the Tiger, but you don't get completely destroyed in Morlock's Mance. You definitely can take the screen transitions, but, you know, how often are you going to get that? I mean, how often are you ever going to have a... one that gets into chapter 4 to beat this time. That's why I'm not going to bother trying to go further. Even though I was so close to the 37. This is 38 already. There's only one other person that's had a 38, and they had the record. That's for good reason. Alright, GG. Goodbye, Tressa. It was fun.